Sawadee Krap. Welcome to Phuket XTRA, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. I'm JP Mestanza, and it's Friday, September 14th, which means the latest edition of the Phuket News is now out. Grab your copy at any one of 600 locations around the island. Now here's the news you need to know. Investigations into possible corruption in Phuket is being handled by Region 8 Police and involves a company being suspiciously awarded a government contract to provide lifeguards on local beaches. Region 8 Police Investigator Lieutenant Colonel Monsak Srisuwan confirmed the news while questioning witnesses at Kamala Police Station earlier this week, saying he's following up on an anonymous complaint filed with Region 8 Police back in May. Although the law does not allow him to reveal any of the parties under investigation from the complaint, he did explain that the complaint focused on how the company had managed to be awarded a government contract to provide lifeguards, despite the fact that the company does not have the resources to provide lifeguards. So far, Lieutenant Colonel Monsak told the Phuket News that the accusations against the parties seem to be true based on evidence they have at the moment, though the investigation is still ongoing. All details from the case will be forwarded to the National Anti-Corruption Commission, the NACC, in Bangkok this week. For more, visit thephuketnews.com. An army conscript is now dead after he fell into a coma allegedly during a disciplinary session which was ordered by three senior conscripts just over 3 weeks ago. 22-year-old Private Kasha Pasha died at a hospital in Lopburi province, succumbing to his injuries after suffering a heart attack back on August 21st, the night he was sent to the hospital. Reports say that the three senior conscripts had confessed to the victim's family that yes, they physically assaulted him during a disciplinary session, and now an army spokesperson is saying that the military will press charges against them, including colluding in an attempted murder, among other charges. It's been a deadly year for sea turtles in Phuket, as one dead sea turtle and two injured sea turtles were found washed up on Maikau Beach just yesterday. Yesterday's discovery on Maikau Beach on the island's northern shores was made by locals, and one marine expert said that the dead hawksbill sea turtle weighed between 45 to 50 kilos, but the two injured Olive Ridley sea turtles are now in the care of the Phuket Marine Biological Center. Marine experts say discarded fishing nets in the sea are to blame, as yesterday's discovery brings the total number of dead sea turtles found washed up on Phuket beaches to 6 total in just September and 11 total for the year. Phuket XTRA will be right back right after this. Welcome back to Phuket XTRA. Thai police are set to visit the UK to question a 19-year-old woman who claims that she was drugged, robbed, and raped on Koh Tao back in June after the British Embassy in Bangkok approved their request. Deputy Tourist Police Chief Police Major General Suracha Hakpan announced today that a team of investigators will head to Britain to question the British backpacker whose story of being raped on Koh Tao was published in the Sun tabloid in the UK, saying that, in addition, Thai police turned her away when she attempted to file a rape complaint. Thai police, who have been investigating the claim since the story appeared in the Sun just last month, they say that they have yet to receive a report on the questioning of the victim, which British police had previously promised to send to Thai police. And investigators in Koh Tao say they have not found any evidence that the incident occurred. Police Major General Surachat says that if the woman's claims turn out to be groundless, they will pursue legal action, which could include blacklisting her from re-entering Thailand. The money that was set aside to compensate Thai nationals who were wrongfully convicted or victims of criminal cases It's already ran dry after just a few months, and now the Justice Ministry is looking for more. About 300 million Thai baht was set aside for fiscal year 2018 to compensate the victims and wrongfully convicted. But most of the money, the Justice Ministry says, has gone to the victims or damaged parties, of which there are over 5,600 people, while 31 others who were wrongfully convicted under the Thai penal system, they received 5.9 million baht. The ministry is now set to ask the government for more funds from the Thai government to compensate those who are on the waiting list, which is about 210 million baht, with officials saying it will be paid within this month. For more, visit thephuketnews.com. And that's it for Phuket Extra, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. For safe, secure, soundproof windows, visit pvcphuket.com. From all of us here at the Phuket News Center, thank you for watching. And until tomorrow, Monday, stay classy, Phuket.